Good morning, my dear students. So, we completed the discussion on the procedures to be followed while writing the chemical formulae of compounds. Symbols are written side by side and their valencies are exchanged. So, using that data, today we focus on calculation of molecular masses. If you have the chemical formula of a compound, then we can calculate the molecular mass of that compound. Molecular mass is the sum of the atomic masses of all the atoms present in that compound. Okay, it is the sum of the molecular masses or atomic masses. Sum of the atomic masses of the participating atoms. For example, water, H2O, is the chemical formula. Then molecular mass of water is sum of atomic masses of hydrogen and oxygen. Sum of atomic masses of hydrogen and oxygen. Remember the table, atomic mass. Okay, so hydrogen atomic mass is 1, oxygen atomic mass is 16. Substitute the values in the formula H2O, 2 hydrogen atoms. So 2 into 1, keep in a bracket, plus 16, that is 18. Another example, molecular mass of nitric acid, HNO3. Remember, atomic mass of H1, nitrogen it is 14, oxygen it is 16. Substitute the values in the formula, that is 1 plus 14 plus 16 into 3, keep in a bracket. 16 into 3, keep in a bracket. Otherwise, calculation lead wrong. So, the value is 63. Another example, sulfuric acid H2SO4. H it is 1, S it is 32, O again 16. So, 1 into 2, keep in a bracket, plus 32, plus 16 into 4, again keep in a bracket. The total will be 98 U. The unit used is U, small letter U, 98 U. So, in this style, we can calculate the molecular masses of compounds. Using this data, we can express the number of atoms in a given quantity of the compound. That term is called mole, M-O-L-E. Mole is the standard unit used to represent number of atoms or molecules or electrons, etc. of a given substance. Mole concept. Okay. The number of particles present in 12 gram of carbon, it is 6.022 into 10 raised to 23. This number is called Avogadro number. 1 gram, a mole of any substance contains 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 atoms. Calculated using devices is the fixed value. 1 gram or a mole of any substance contains Avogadro number. So, we'll calculate how many moles are there in the given substance. Then, that mole into Avogadro number gives the number of atoms present in the given substance. Okay. A mole represents two things. It represents a definite number of particles, means atoms or molecules or ions. equal to 6.022 into 10 raised to 23. It represents a definite mass of a substance equal to the gram atomic mass of an element or gram molecular mass of a compound. Gram atomic mass is atomic mass expressed in gram. Gram molecular mass is atomic mass expressed in grams. Okay. So gram atomic mass of an element 16. Oxygen it is 16. Then 1 mole of nitrogen means O2. 16 into 2 it is 32. Gram molecular mass of a compound, for example water, it is 18 gram, expressing in grams. Okay. Then relationship between number of moles, small letter N, mass, small letter M, molar mass, capital M, and Avogadro number N0, number of atoms or molecules, capital N. So remember these value formulae. N, number of moles, equal to M by capital M, molar mass, given amount divided by molecular mass, or N equal to number of atoms, capital N divided by N0. N0 means Avogadro number, or M, small m, or given amount equal to N into capital N. N means small n means number of moles, capital N number of atoms. So remember the formulae. We are asked to use these formulae in the calculation. Calculate the number of moles. Number of moles equal to given amount divided by molecular mass. 1 mole equal to 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 atoms. So the calculated mole means that number into 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 gives the number of atoms present in that substance. Okay, so we'll do the calculations also. That's all today. Thank you.